are at the Minnesota State Fair today, and we're gonna walk through as much of the fair as we can see before my battery dies. So, let's check out the fair. This is the 2023 State Fair. We're at what I believe is the main entrance. We're gonna take a walk through. Overcast, breezy, nice and cool here at the fair. It's supposed to get pretty hot today. It does get pretty hot here at the fair sometimes. A lot of pavement. The Blue Barn here on the left is a popular place with different food items. I'd love to take the time to show each and every booth and what they're gonna have at each one, but just simply don't think we have the time or capacity to do that. So we'll look at what we can and hopefully you enjoy the video. Kind of redone area of the fair in the last, I think, decade or so. A lot of the buildings in this area are newer. The History and Heritage Center there, I believe, you can go into and is somewhat of like a museum about the fair and stuff. So you can learn a bit more about the history of the fair. Heritage Square, if I'm reading everything correctly. Lots of booths, different things for sale. It is about 9:30 a.m., so some things are still opening up. The fair, I think, opens at 7 or so pretty early in the day, but a lot of the booths and things don't open until 9. And then the stage, different stages, I think the music starts 10, 11, a little later in the day. Margaret Schilling Amphitheater, also known as like the Shell Stage. One of the longer, I guess more sought after items this morning is the Nordic waffles. There's like sausage and salmon and different things wrapped in a waffle. We knocked over the goat. Yeah, so, and this is where you get the dill pickle lemonade. A popular new item at the fair that I think a lot of people are eager to try. You put a pickle on it, you put it in a deep fryer, and it's bound to be a hit here. Skyride on the left, which will take you to about the middle of the fair, kind of a central area. Was gonna record a quick video on there, but they told me I couldn't, so, oh well. State Fair Police Station. Heard a lot of good things about the cream puffs, so the cream puff stand. Yeah. All sorts of different food items and things that people are excited to try. So you can see it's a pretty densely crowded area, but for how crowded this Minnesota State Fair gets, this is 9:30 a.m. on the first day. It's a little overcast. It'll be significantly more crowded here on a busier day. I saw this while walking around earlier. Probably one of the better deals I've seen at the fair. Two slices of pizza for $4. Killer, considering how much some of this stuff costs here. I think. Well, people come to places like this and have a lot of complaints about prices and lines and things, but you just gotta know what you're getting into and approach it with the right mentality and plan and budget ahead of time so you can have a good time. Fluffy's hand-cut donuts. I had not noticed this in the past when I've been to the fair. And then I saw it this morning while I was wandering around before a lot of things opened up. And got all these different donuts in here. And then the special today was the dill pickle donut. Which, yeah, I got the dill pickle donut. I tried it. I am a sucker for trying something unique and I want to say creative because that's not something you'd expect to see a pickle on, but with the pickle being the star of the state fair this year, I guess it's kind of a natural progression. But yeah, it was pretty good. So instead of having regular frosting, we had cream cheese, so more of a savory type donut. Definitely a cool idea, and I think they did it well. I was worried about like the pickle having like some like pickle juice on it that would not sit well, but it went well. It's good. Hot dish on a stick, Minnesotan for casserole, I guess. They'll tell you it's different. Often made with tater tots. Giant bell pepper. Are you? cinnamon and pecan rolls look really good, smell really good. One of the interesting things about walking through this day of fair is beyond just seeing all the food and the different vendors and the fun stuff is looking at the architecture and the way that buildings have changed, and you're taking this walk through time, through history, as you see the different styles of the buildings here, and then even moving on to over in the corner, you have these more recent additions. So you just get all these different styles of architecture, different building styles. Sort of like the idea of the Mid-State, so to say, fair, where you're bringing all these different people from all these different parts of the state together to just celebrate and enjoy something together and have a good time. Get to you. This might not be the best place to visit, but lots of cute pigs. There used to be little piglets right by the door there. I don't know if they've gotten moved. have to be aware of droppings and poop on the ground when walking through the fair, especially places like this. Yeah, thank you. Casual cow crossing. Compeer Arena. Judging going on in there. Celebrating 30 years of the movie. So I intentionally walked by the midway because it wasn't open yet, so none of the rides are up. So what I'll do is take a walk around the whole fair and then end in that area because we'd rather walk through when the rides are on. So if we miss that, I'll probably have another video up later that might be more focused on that. The Gopher Dairy Bar. Saw someone giving positive reviews of that spot to get milk and milkshakes and all that stuff. Or sorry, not milk, milkshakes and ice cream there, apparently. Pretty good. Horses. Very cool Art Deco style building. I'm doing a quick walkthrough when I go through these places, but there's so much to see, so much education and so many different activities. You want to learn about different breeds, about what's going on in the different buildings. There's so much to see and so much to learn. Way more than can be condensed into 1 hour to an hour and a half long video. Building. Another one with a strong scent. Got some sheep turkey right here hanging out. And then if you look closely, you can see the turkey to go sign right there. Very interesting. I walk through here with my wife sometimes, and she's always like, oh, it makes me a little uncomfortable to walk through and see the poultry and then have them just right out there, but I get that. Lots of rabbits, buttons, chickens. Gonna head out. This is heading out of that. Excuse me, sorry. We got the Lee and Rose Warner Coliseum, a large building referred to by some as somewhat of a brutalist architecture, but really like the Le Tour du Nord, the Star of the Nord engraving in here. Kind of adds a little bit to a somewhat less ornamental building. Adds some nice ornamentation to it. That is on both sides there. A massive structure. Let's walk through here really quick and see if we can take a look inside the Colosseum, if there's anything going on in there. But they have events in here year round. Different booths and things for sale inside there to check out. $2 all-you-can-drink milk stand. Who knows how many of those exist globally. This is the only one I've ever seen. And there are people who, you know, love the all-you-can-drink milk stand. I've talked to people in the past and I'm like, oh, you know, so you're going to the state fair. What is it that you're most looking forward to? What are you excited about? And I do remember having a friend who's like, oh, my family, we always go to the all-you-can-drink milk stand. And thought it was a bit, but they were being serious. They said they'd grab cookies and walk over and hang up by the all-you-can-drink milk stand. Their family would drink glasses of milk and eat the bucket of cookies. Whatever creates a memorable bonding moment with the people you love, right? We're not here to judge, we're here to enjoy. Got the pig. This is the Miracle of Birth building. The Miracle of Life. Pregnant animals birthing or about to give birth. A lot of people around here, so you might have some live birth in action right now. Mama just gave birth. See, brand new baby cat. Well, we're about 30 minutes through our walkthrough in the 2023 Minnesota State Fair, so thank you for watching so far. Oh my gosh. We got some people taking some birth announcement photos. How fun. What a fitting place for that. I walked by the cheese curd tacos. So back there, there's a booth that is making cheese curd tacos. It's very unique, interesting idea. I know last year that was, I think, a new item and was one of the more popular new items at the fair. Department of National Resources, Natural Resources Area, not national. Got this stage here. Darlene and the boys. Pond. Building canoes over here. This guy had a snake. Some different Minnesota wildlife through there. DNR fire tower that you can hike up. If I have time, I will come back and wait in the line at the end of the video and walk up there, but does not make for great content to be standing in line for a while, so I'll keep walking and hope the battery lasts that long. Cafe Caribe. So I don't remember how I walked through last year in order to get as much on video as possible, but kind of zigzagging this time. Free corn dogs, cheese curds, and funnel cakes from Auntie M. I think it says the Adventure Park at the Minnesota State Fair. It's like a bus drop-off spot. The fried pork chop on a stick is a very popular food. I believe they sell the seasoning there too. I know some people who get that seasoning and use it year round. The fresh French fry food, also another very popular state fair item. I always found this pretty hilarious. This morning when I was walking by, you have U.S. Senator Amy Klobuchar right in front of the MyPillow. Very, very Minnesotan right there. Hi.
fridge. You can take it within your pocket. We've got more cups.
Wild rice. Minnesota State Green. Coming up on the one and only Minnesota butter sculptures. We're in the dairy building. Christ, cheeses, and butter. These are all going to be carved into the bus. There is the one and only 70th Princess K of the Milky Way.
And so they carve the winner in them?
I think they do everything.
Dairy goodness, oats, yogurt, cheese, milk, cone, sundaes. Haunted house. Enter if ye dare. Why is it you dare, not he? And my favorite building at the State Fair, the Agriculture Horticulture Building. We're gonna check out the, I think it's the International Bazaar over here, really quick, before going in there. Looking at that building a little more.
Is it all my shirt?
Global Market is going to have different restaurants from Midtown Global Market throughout the week, I believe. Today it is Momodosa. Henry's with some of the more interesting new foods, the crispy lutefisk steamed lutefisk, which is like a pickled fish. It is a kind of Minnesota icon. Probably something I will be trying throughout my time here at the fair later. Minnesota Twins baseball team. Tomato. This is the booth selling what they're calling a stuffed tomato. I wonder what that is. Doesn't look like it has pictures. Of the Pig Burger. The fair's only full service restaurant. Another Latil du Nord crest or emblem up there. The corn engraving on the side. Faux columns. Ton of information to bring in. Oh my goodness, it's Hansel and Gretel. And when you're in here, do not forget to look up. Just really cool ceiling lighting through there. Fairy tale theme going on with some of the art in the center of the building. Giant pumpkins and the different prized fruits and vegetables.
Check the theater again.
Wow, it has almost been an hour. I might have to pick up the pace a bit. Minnesota fruits, the First Kiss apple, delicious apple made by the grown at the Minnesota, I think University of Minnesota Agriculture Program. One thing that I love about coming to the state fair is you come here and you're trying all this fried food, all this different delicious greasy stuff, and it's so heavy and intense. And then you can try the so there's the line to get into the seed art, I believe. So you can try those apples that really kind of cut down that intense flavor that you'll be having. And it's a nice break in the heavy food. And it's an absolutely delicious apple. So this is the famous Minnesota seed art at the state fair. Often overshadowed by the seed art is the scarecrows, which are so fun, but not to be missed. ice cream. Statue of Liberty.
Excuse me.
Sorry.
I have a school stuff on the shirt.
And this is the other end of the sky ride. Take a quick walk through the food building. Thing that'll take you up for a view of the fair from above. Says hi. Hopefully he got in the frame.
We'll be back for more later. Don't worry.
Spice is the new nice. Love it. Frame, but he had like a giant alien, a tub of cheese curds, and a pineapple in his hand that had a straw in it. He was living. That is peak State Fair energy.
Yeah.
in the back there, up Herbivore's Butcher, his Kale, who was one of the owners of that place, makes some of the food there. Really good stuff. I think this is the oldest ride at the state fair. Little boat ride. Really quick one. Well, see, there's that giant alien that guy had. We are 1 hour into the video. Thank you for watching. And Minnesota Republicans over there. If you're enjoying the State Fair walk, and if you would like to see more of Minnesota, and places, and what things are like currently in Minnesota, feel free to, subscribe to the channel, and like the video, share it with your friends. Taking the time to catalog certain places in time in Minnesota and having people along for the walk with me makes it that much cooler. Mancini's. There's a great place next to Mancini's there that was pretty popular this morning. Likely those more breakfast style items are gonna be a hit during the early hours of the day. It's probably about 10:30 today right now, if I'm not mistaken. As always, I could be wrong. I actually have a watch now. Yeah, 10:33. Giant slide, $4 a ride. Worth every penny for a special memory. TV over there for the Fox 9 channel. Grandstand right here in front of us. Very cool brick structure. I don't recall specifically when it was built, but nice aging building that has stood the test of time. The Black Keys are playing there tonight. Corn Roast, a very popular stand at the State Fair. Midwestern sweet corn. The idea of corn-fed Midwesterners is, I guess, real with that being such a popular food, but it's good. Definitely worth checking out if you're ever at the fair. Independence party. There's arcades and a butterfly thing across the way there. Oh, we got the sun starting to come out. Hopefully it'll come out a little more before my walk ends. This is the 1919 root beer booth. You can get it in a float. Delicious with or without ice cream. Fan Central. Lots of the sports teams and stuff in here. Minnesota Roller Derby. St. Paul Saints. The one and only Minnesota Aurora.
I would.
Foosball. Minnesota United back here. Another spin wheel. Some sort of VR thing it looks like. It's kind of like a corn dog, a little bit different. I think it's like pancake batter instead of a regular corn dog batter. Wiener done in a bun, a banquet on a stick. Got the line to spin a wheel. Coffee house. I think we had a latte from there last year and it was a pretty good coffee. And then some anti-Joe Biden stuff, fighting lockdown governor. Ballpark Cafe. They think they have some craft beers that are specific to this area. We're going to see some of the stuff that's made for the state fair. There's all sorts of creative and unique beers that different local breweries make for the fair. Garden, I think there's some sort of, oh yeah, like frozen beer garita or something that people get in here that tends to be popular. Chicago Dogs, looks like they're safe. Fried Buckeye from here last year. Really, really good. It's like a peanut butter wrapped in chocolate, deep fried. Obviously just terrible for you, but delicious food. The giant egg roll is another one of those State Fair staples that people really love. Agriculture, horticulture building. First Blue Ribbon award-winning root beer float.
Okay.
Alright, so I am going to skip this road that's ahead of us. On the left, you're going to have the kid way. It's like little kiddie rides and stuff like that. And then lots of different vendors. We're going to go along this side of the fair. It's a little closer to this side of the fair there. And then cut up around the back. And see how far we make it. The Minnesota DFL, the Democrat booth. You want to meet some politicians? You've got the one and only Ilhan Omar in the house at the moment. Farmers Union here has a pretty popular food building. They've got coffee. I think they did this pork schnitzel last year that was really popular. Creative Activities Building. So all of the art and craft and food contest buildings are awesome, but I simply do not have the time to walk through the entire thing, which is unfortunate because there's so many people who put so much work into making things for the fair, and I'd love to show it all, but what's important to me is getting through as much as possible to show you all as much of the fair as I can. But we will peek into each building. Rick's Pizza? Is that the pickle pizza? Yeah, that was a really popular item last year. Pickles are kind of the star of the fair. Hey, we got a Messi jersey. healing garden. Aloe vera, elderberry, goji berry. Building. Minnesota Newspaper Museum. Well, I just got a notification that my cell phone battery is down to 20%, which could mean the battery will die in 5 minutes, could mean a half an hour. You never know. This kind of depends on the conditions outside and what it's feeling like on that given day. So if the battery dies at some point, thanks again for watching, and I hope you have a great rest of your day. I hope you either have fond memories of the Minnesota State Fair that this might bring back for you, or it might help you to prepare to make some new memories. This is the family fair at Baldwin Park. Lots of kids stuff, math on a stick. Yeah, lots of fun stuff for kids throughout the fair. Oh my goodness, I think I see a giant loon. Here's the crazy maze. This is the Salem Lutheran Church dining hall. Advertising a Swedish egg coffee. Ferris wheel. is like, I think it's like little farmhands by Kemp's. I believe really fun little thing to take if you have young kids through that, like, yeah, younger, maybe pre-kindergarten age where they play on the top. I think they get free ice cream in it too. Giggles Campfire Grill is a very popular spot that has specific food and drink that you can only find at the fair. S'mores beer, rhubarb shandy. The old tractors. Water trolley driving around the fair. It is the gizmo put on the map by Andrew Zimmern. Very popular food item. It's like a Italian beef sandwich, like a chopped beef sandwich, kind of with cheese and I believe marinara sauce. The sky glider. Is the sweet and selfie experience. Here's the hangar. I believe this is the north entrance of the Minnesota State Fair. Thank you. Skateboard ramp where this is now. Another spin wheel, this time for jelly beans. Oh my god, I bought it. Giant Candyland. In the candy shop. Jammy Sammy's Brim. Yeah. Can-Can Wonderland's mini golf on a stick. Can-Can Wonderland is a mini golf course in St. Paul. I believe it's St. Paul, yeah. That does really creative holes. Play on. Very fun place to go. I think it's for kids and adults as opposed to some of the more creative mini golf courses that are adults only. This is the hangar. So that is a majority of the fair. We did skip that one central area. We're walking back on this road that will, that's pretty short. Hey. might get to see part of the midway in time before the battery runs out. Martha's cookies.
Oh, okay.
Got a robot out here. It's STEM day at the state fair today. So there's all sorts of fun activities for kids to do different STEM stuff in front of the grandstand. Which, oh, I believe I skipped over that, unfortunately. Agua fresca. This is another food area. There's Scenic 61, which has lobster and seafood. The Summer Lake place back here has, like, I think, non-alcoholic mixers and stuff. And then Baba's is, I think, Mediterranean. All well-reviewed places. Unfortunately, we did just get the 10% remaining battery notification. So just as the sun starts to come out and the day becomes perfect for a walking through the fair video, my battery starts to die. But isn't that the way it goes sometimes? Well, until the battery dies, thank you for watching, and whenever it does cut out, I wish you a great rest of your day. Hopefully it cuts out when I'm mid-thought or mid-sentence and just assume that whatever I was saying was, like, really mind-blowing and relevant. And if I would have just finished it, it probably would have changed the world, but unfortunately that's where the video cut out. Thank you. To the left is the kidway. Smaller kids rides. Looks like there's some Mall of America stuff going on. They are the sponsor of the day. Do have a spot down in, I want to say, Bloomington or Richfield, where you can take your kids in to go play on their different structures that they make. I think it's like $1 or something like that.
Brandon wants the dog.
There's a way to get people to check out the structures. Is the State Fair mascot, Fairchild? So we are back by the grandstand. Inside of the grandstand, there's all sorts of exhibitors and vendors and people selling different items. Lots of cool stuff to check out in there.
Like
fried olives on a stick. Hamburger. And so here is that stem area which I was speaking of a little earlier. They do different stuff in this area every day. I think one day is like Firefighters Day and Rescue Day, all sorts of different stuff. Today is STEM Day. Here, fried ravioli.
Hey, was that John Hunter?
So we're getting close to the midway. Maybe you'll get to see part of it. That donut booth we walked by earlier. So we've essentially done a whole loop less the midway. Cheese on a stick. And lemonade. The baby bucket of fries.
Look at the size of the dog.
All right, we made it to the midway. Another ride here. Well, I'm very surprised. It is an hour and 45 minutes. We're gonna cut out any moment. But I think last year we made it right to 1 hour 50 minutes also. So, very telling of the battery life of the iPhone XS. Hasn't deteriorated over that last year, I guess. I don't know. Maybe it has. On his castle. Love the rides like that in the game. The zipper.
Hey, I wasn't gonna say nothing, but she was looking more serious. How y'all doing?
Iron Dragon roller coaster. Midway ticket prices in 2023.
Stay winning.